Now, karma yoga simply means a time, a space, a situation, a person, an activity, and its effect. This is the combination. And performing that with full conviction, full commitment, full application, and full acceptance. This is the karma yoga, right? You are not resisting. You are not in conflict with the situation. You are not screaming, shouting, you know, trying to push things away. Instead, okay, this is happening now. This is my situation today or right now. And I'm doing what I can in here. So sometimes all these situations are not suitable for us. Sometimes this is not what we wanted. But again, since you have to tackle it, you tackle it. Especially without expecting a result or a prescribed result. You know, if you are not really worried about the result of action, then you have freedom in it. Then you can perform very well. Whatever the results are, it's okay. And the results will lead to further of such incidents or further such things. And that's how life goes. So being yourself, number one, you have to be yourself. Totally be yourself. Secondly, be fearless. Very important. Third, be flexible. Very important. Just look at these three combinations. How will your life be? It'll be blooming, you know, it'll be full of wonder. And you would actually excel your own capacities. You will feel much better. You know, you will feel great because you are flexible, you are fearless, and you know very well that that's the most important thing, like our connection with the guru or God. We know whatever happens, even if the whole world leaves you, the master will never leave you. That one confidence is enough to be fearless. He will never abandon you. God will never abandon you. And also, now coming to this subject, we must say a God is always unconditional. As I said in the beginning, in the creation, I said, when elements are delicately assembled into a form and energy is put into form as the soul, soul has always been neutral. Soul has never been imposing itself on us. We have never had a soul which told us what to do, how to behave, or how to be in the world. But we wanted the soul. Just like electricity is not telling you, I don't want to be in a washing machine, rather I'd be in a refrigerator. Electricity never says that. Whichever machine it gets to work, it works. Like that, the soul works in any machine. It can be a tiger's body, it can be a lion's body, it can be a deer's body, a buffalo's body, a rat's body, or a human body. It works the same. So, soul is so neutral, and that exactly is the God particle that we need to connect within us. So, when we connect to that soul particle within us, we realize this is similar to the electricity in these machines. The electricity never ever said, I don't like this machine, or you change this machine or do something else. Like that, soul is always neutral. So when you start connecting to that energy element inside us, we start to learn to be neutral. That is why we have to contemplate. We start being neutral. When we start being neutral in all our aspects of life, we learn to detach. This is detachment. Because being neutral is being free. Ownership binds us. And the soul, as I said right from the beginning, the soul has no interest. Like the electricity has no interest. But it comes along and it performs through machines. So when electricity performs through a washing machine, we call it a washing machine. We don't see the electricity, so we don't know. Like that, we don't see the soul, so we do not really know. But soul is always silent, always neutral, always energetic. It has no, it is beyond all three states like waking, dream, deep sleep. It's always there for you. So when we start connecting to that soul aspect and start connecting to the energy within us, it's basically the energy within us, And we start connecting to it frequently, consistently for a period of time, then we tend to become neutral. And then you perform in the world, that is karma yoga. You perform in the world without ownerships, without any kind of likes and dislikes, without expectations, it's karma yoga. And when you surrender all these, the fruits of actions to, or the benefits of all these actions at the feet of Guru or God, that is karma sannyasa, renunciation of karma. So this is as simple as that. So I always say that early wakers, early birds should always use this time to contemplate on what is inside. What is the energy which is running this body, this mind, intellect, ego, this personality, all these things. There is somebody who is running all this. And that person has no interest. It's not getting any gratification out of it. Body is experiencing something, mind is getting gratification. Mind stores some things. That becomes memory. Memory asks for more of that kind of thing. Like that, life goes. So when the soul leaves the body, originally the soul was totally neutral, it also has something attached to it, desires. So it carries those desires when it goes. And then it takes another body because they have there is desires to fulfill. So this is something which continues and on and on and on through lifetimes. So then it's if you look at it, it's all role play. You're an actor, you're acting various roles, and you're just enjoying them. There is a gratification. That's why I always say there is nothing called sacrifice. There is a gratification even in a sacrifice. You know, so actually, this is how life works. And being neutral is very important. Less expectation, more freedom. And that makes you a very powerful personality in the society. Whether people recognize you, appreciate you, or they call you eccentric, that's different. It doesn't matter. But they can't ignore you. They can't ignore you. This is the whole point.